Well, good afternoon, everybody, and welcome to yet another edition of the, I almost said Sonoma Valley music scene, because that was the show that we used to do back. This is the new old show, and it's the new version of the old show that we used to do that, that bumper music. According to that bumper music, in case you're wondering, that's Joe Satriani. Summer Song off The Extremist, I think, was the album. And him and Steve Vai are coming to Luther Burbank. I picked up some tickets just the other night when I was on the Instagram. So on the gram, scrolling through, they said two new dates announced. I went to the Luther Burbank site. I tried to buy tickets. I almost threw my phone. But I did eventually buy the tickets, and it all worked out. But anyway, it's the new old show. And we used to, back in the day, we used to bring in musicians, and they were typically rock musicians that played electric stuff. And we forced them to play acoustic songs for a half hour or so on the show, and we played strictly Sonoma Valley music. It was a two-hour show, and we had some great performances in there. And it was just about a year ago. In fact, the guys that are coming, the guys at 5 after this show, you want to stay tuned, they have Littleworth live in the studio. So we got two back-to-back shows where we've got live musicians today. Littleworth, back then they were called, it's going to escape me, the name. Anyway, we were doing some end of the year thing, and they needed somebody to interview a band. And so I came in and interviewed these guys for an hour. And after the show, it just dawned on me. It's like, you dope. Why aren't you doing this? This is way more fun. And this is what you're supposed to be doing. And so another few months of, deep tracks. That's because I was trying to be, there's only one Earl Bailey, unfortunately, and I'm not him. So we were doing in deep. We were trying to play deep classic rock cuts, and that was fine, and that was fun. But anyway, we decided we were going to do the new old show. So we've made one full season. This will be our 27th episode of the year. Next year we'll have more, I think, because we didn't start this till the end of May. Or June even, and next year we're going to be starting right away on January 3rd with local musicians from Napa, Sonoma, Petaluma. If you know somebody that you think should be on the show and subject them to all of my witty banter, then reach out to the radio station. I could probably give you my email. I mean, it's fairly simple, jmberry@ksvy.org. Shoot me an email and tell me, hey, I got this guy, or my brother needs to be on your show, or whatever that may be. But today on the new old show, we have somebody who I've full disclosure here, I've known this kid since literally the day he was born. He grew up across the street from my house, and I watched him grow up, and his dad was my drummer. No, wait a minute. We want to rephrase that. We didn't want any Charlie Watts incidents. So I was his dad's guitar player, singer, and bass player at various times in a number of different bands. So like Charlie said, you're my singer. I'm not your drummer. So we don't want any of that going around. But his dad, Mike, was our drummer. So today we have child number 3 of the Schimms, Max Schimm, in the studio with us. How are you doing, man?
Hey, James. Thanks for having me, man. It's an honor to be on the last episode of the season.
The final finale show.
An honor. Appreciate it.
Well, like I say, I've known you since forever. But for whatever reason, I did not know, you lived across the street from us, and then when you moved over to the east side, I didn't see you guys as much. And I had no idea that, out of all three of your other siblings, that you were fully into music. Because we didn't, at that point in time, when we had band practice, it was usually up at Nazar's, up on Wolf Run. And so, but I guess that during this whole time, your dad was playing with you over there. And Donnie Trotta would drop by sometimes and all kinds of things. So, all of a sudden you were in your 20s. And here's this singing guitar player guy, and I'm like, well, when did this happen? So clearly there was always music in your house, but you're the only one of the four that decided I want to do this music thing. Was there a time that you saw your dad or saw something on TV that you said, okay, I'm really into this music thing, or maybe you just wanted to play drums like your dad? How did that all happen? How did that get started?
Well, I did start off as a drummer, believe it or not. So I think when I was about 10 or 11 years old, my pops sat me down and showed me how to play just a basic 4-4 groove on the kit. And I never pursued it too much because I didn't have a lot of friends who were into music the way that I was. So for drumming, in terms of drumming, it kind of started and ended in my parents' garage for a bit. But my dad turned me on to like Zeppelin and Toto, like literally the best records you could ever hear as a drummer.
Oh, right.
And so
right,
to this day,
Bonham who's the drummer? It's Picaro, right?
Picaro, yeah. And Bonham, of course. So like to this day, even though I sing and strum guitar a lot more than I play the drums, I always consider myself a drummer first and foremost. It's the first thing I hear in like any music is the drums or the percussion.
Well, the world needs more drummers than bass players.
So yeah,
keep that in your mind.
That's true.
Although you gotta
I always switch back.
Oh, you always gotta have a van to move your stuff.
That's the only
problem.
And so music's always just been there for me, and I really got into a lot more rock and roll in my later like high school years. Is kind of when I really was discovering every Rush, and like in college I really got into Zeppelin and the Doors, which were we'll be talking about today. But I think college is where I really picked up the guitar some more and met some people who I could jam with and really find all my favorite classic rock records. And that's kind of where I discovered a lot of who I am, and the music that I love. So.
And that was up at Chico State.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah,
which is a funny coincidence because we back 40 years earlier, I guess it was 40 years. I mean, when were you up in Chico?
From 2014 to 2018. So
okay, so yeah, almost a full 40 years earlier, we were up there from 80 to 85, and our band Southbound. I mean, we formed Southbound up in Chico,
right?
And we played all. Well, I didn't because I wasn't actually enrolled in Chico. I didn't actually go to college. I'd get off work at 4:30 or 4:45, jump in, maybe have my car loaded with gear at work, drive right up to Chico, and it was only if you knew the back roads, you can get up there. Back then, the speed everything.
You
could get up there in 2 hours and change
for sure.
And so by 6:30, I'd be up there, and I was up there every week. And people just thought I went there. I even had a raised liquor. I even had a raised liquor card.
That's how you know.
Yeah. So we played the Oasis and all that kind of stuff. And definitely, it was nice to see that there's still music. People of your age playing live music because it's a rare thing. I mean, my kids could they proved to themselves they could play music if they wanted to. I mean, they were both, they went to Waldorf, and you play music there, and I think my son even had a band for a month or something with some of his buddies. I don't really know. These days, if he goes to a show, or a lot of the kids these days, they're going to Las Vegas Motor Speedway, and it's the electronic Daze Carnival or something like that, where there's 85 guys with laptops and laser shows, and it happens at night, and it goes till 6 in the morning, and you got 30,000-50,000 people on Molly running around Las Vegas.
Yeah.
So it's nice to see live music.
Yeah, I definitely have an appreciation for the live stuff. It touches my soul a little bit more than the EDM scene, but I try not to be...
EDM, is that the scene?
The electronic dance music.
There you go. I know. I'm writing that down because I'm old.
Yeah, don't forget.
Yeah.
What are we talking about? That's what they're into these days. Yeah.
Well, now, okay, so you're grooving on classic rock and stuff.
Yeah.
When you started playing guitar, were those the songs you were into, or did you reach back further as to like where these roots come? Did you ever hit some early blues or do any traditional acoustic music? Or from a guitar standpoint.
Yeah, I think my dad bought me and my brother guitars when I was in like the seventh grade, and maybe my brother was a sophomore in high school.
So your dad was an enabler and all that.
Yeah, sure, okay, sure. But I never touched it until maybe my junior year of high school. I decided to pick it up because I heard Sweet Child of Mine. I thought, boy, I got to learn how to play this.
Yeah, me too.
I hate the fact that it's that song,
Right, well, I'm still thinking that. I do not know that lick.
Yeah. Well, I learned it, and then I forgot it. I could never play that song.
Well, apparently
now,
it was a guitar. It was an exercise, a fingering exercise that Slash used to do. And Axl came out one day and said, hey, what's that?
Yeah, yeah.
And they wrote a song off this fingering exercise that Slash's
guitar
teacher taught him.
That's funny, man. The same thing happened, I think, for Life in the Fast Lane by the Eagles,
Yeah.
Same sort of story there. But, I just was self-taught, or rather YouTube-taught. I would search up videos on how to play
So you didn't take any local lessons?
No, I wish I did.
Born and raised here.
Born and raised here, yeah.
Sonoma boy.
Yeah, I never really thought about it. I just figured I've got these resources at my disposal. I can YouTube or use like Ultimate Guitar and learn the tabs, you know.
This was an acoustic guitar or an electric guitar?
This was an electric to begin with. And then, then my parents bought me an acoustic, I think, later that year. So, and then it was mostly acoustic stuff from there because it's a lot easier and I don't have to plug everything in and I'm lazy like that, you know? Let me just grab my acoustic and play instead of, you know.
We used to wheel around Marshall stacks. Now if I can't bring it all in the club in one trip, this is a bad gig.
Yeah, yeah. But I've been playing a lot of electric now too. I've got a cool house over in Alvarado in a studio room, so I've been setting up there and
we're neighbors.
Making some noise.
Yeah. How do I not know these things?
I'm back in
you're
town,
back,
man.
You're back on the west side.
Yeah, that's right. There you go, the right side.
No offense, east siders. So did you ever entertain writing songs? You ever tried to write songs?
I do. I have been writing some riffs and some lyrics, but nothing's quite ready to pull out of the oven yet, you know.
Are they more electric?
They're definitely more electric, yeah. Okay. So a lot of them probably wouldn't translate as well to acoustic anyways. And like when I do write a song, it's a lot of – I hear a lot of the drums and like bass in my head already. So right. It's like very band-centric.
I didn't ever thought Nirvana would translate to acoustic.
Oh, yeah.
But Nirvana so Unplugged well. Is probably one of the finest MTV Unplugged things ever recorded.
Everything from that
so
era,
you,
man.
You wouldn't think that, you know, a lot of, they say if you can play a song acoustically, it's a well-written song. So, So when you write songs for electric, I dare say there's probably a way to play them acoustically.
I'm sure there is. Yeah. I think there is. But
you're gearing toward electric.
That's what I
Now, do you have, when you first started playing, were there other than your brother and your dad?
Yeah.
You say there weren't many kids around. So did you ever have a band in high school or any of that kind of
thing? No, man. I wish, you know, there's a lot of guys my age who I did go to high school with and they were in bands and I just never, you know, I guess I just was focused on other things at the time and I wish
you're an
it.
Athlete too.
I was a good baseball player, wrestling, and baseball. That's kind of what I was focusing on. But when I found guitar and kind of dove into music in my like junior and senior year, I was like, this is what I can do after wrestling's over. You know, that was my passion at the time. But like when I was going into college, I was like, this is what I can do with my free time.
It's not really wrestling for a living unless you're going to be Randy Savage or somebody.
That's right, you know? Yeah.
There's only one Randy Savage.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah. Hey, we're going to take a quick break. We have to mention our sponsor. We're going to be right back. You're listening to 91.3 KSVY-FM Sonoma. I am your host, James Marshall Berry. We're here live with Max Schimm in the studio. And we're going to hear a word from our sponsors. We're going to be back and hear a song and a little more from Max as we have him here for the whole hour. In fact, the door is closed. He can't leave. If you are thinking about becoming a sponsor on 91.3, we would love to have you. There's monthly packages, there's yearly packages. In fact, your brand or your company could be mentioned right after I press this button if you were a sponsor. And of course, the morning show, and they'll give you all that information. I try to stay out of all the who, what's, wherefores, and whys. But there's all sorts of sponsor information, some sponsor packets. You can point your browser to ksvy.org and check it out. And you can fill out a sponsor form, or you can email our production coordinator, Ronnie Joe Grooms. His email is on there as well. And if you do nothing else, when you go to the website, subscribe to the newsletter. It'll keep you up to date on all the things we're doing, things that are happening, special things that are not only happening on KSVY, but on Sonoma TV. Say you want to know if that school board meeting is going to be aired. So, or maybe you missed the school board meeting, you read about it in the Index Tribune, and you're going, who said what about who? And you need to go back and see it. You can go to the Sonoma TV YouTube channel, and all those meetings are archived, so we can keep an eye on our elected government officials. And that is one of the great things about community radio and our television station on Comcast 27 or on YouTube, Sonoma TV on YouTube. In the meantime, without further ado, here's a word from our sponsors. And just like that, we are back. Here on 91.3 KSVY-FM Sonoma. Thank you, Rabbi Steve, who has his show on a date and time that you would think I would know since I'm going to talk about it. But I don't. But if you point your browser to ksvy.org, you can look at our shows, and it has the entire schedule. I'd like to think that Rabbi Steve's show is on you know, Saturday, because Sunday, I don't know a lot about the religion. I barely know about the one I was raised in, which is, you know, Catholicism, that it's probably not even legal to say. Back in the day, it said you were an Italian Catholic because you went to church on, you know, Easter and Christmas.
Oh, yeah.
So there was a lot of that going on. Anyway, we're live, and I'm sure I have no offense to any Italians out there. I am Italian. Does that mean I can make fun of myself? I'm not even sure if that's legal anymore. Regardless, we are here live in the studio with Max Schimm, and talking with him on the new old show here on 91.3. So, like I say, you never did any... Oh, Ronnie Joe, who is apparently listening to the show. Rabbi Steve is on at 3 o'clock on Thursdays. Thank you, Ronnie, for chiming in. So you can catch out Rabbi Steve and get your dose of what Rabbi Steve... You can pick up what Rabbi Steve is putting down Thursdays at 3 o'clock. Anyway, back to what we were talking about, which was if you'd ever written some songs... on electric. Let's just get to a song before I talk maybe right into a tunnel. when you started doing cover tunes, and God forbid we get into that whole discussion.
Oh boy.
Oh, Facebook thing.
I think we will.
The Facebook thing is hilarious. Like I told David Dempsey, my buddy, chimed in, and I said I was going to get a tribute cat for my tabby that passed away. I got to get a tribute cat for this guy, you know, because he's not around anymore. Oh, I can't hear his songs.
Yeah.
I can't hear his hits. I got to get a tribute cat.
That's right.
Yeah. So, when you decided to play, songs that you like, what is it that is it because it's easy or it's because I want to play it?
I am very inspired by songs that I hear. The Doors, for example, I love The Doors, and
it's amazing that you love The Doors because I mean, Jim Morrison died 40 something years before you were born, or 30 years before you were born.
Well, what's wild about them is they were only around for a run of 4 years.
Yeah.
And, like, let's look at the impact that they've made. You know,
Leonard Skinner was famous as a band for 3 and Change.
Yeah, wow.
They released that first album in 74, or the plane went down in 77.
Wow, I didn't know it was that quick.
That was their candle, and their music lives on to this day as well.
Right, right.
So it is amazing with the Doors. And, you know, people always say, well, the Doors never had a bass player. Well, they did when they toured.
they did in the studio. I don't know if they've ever...
Occasionally they did, but when they toured, they had to have a bass player because Ray wasn't going to do all of... I'm too busy watching, making sure Jim doesn't fall off the stage.
Yeah, right.
Well, what do you got for us here?
I'm going to go ahead and do a Doors tune.
Oh, my heavens.
Yeah.
People are going to be angry. People are going to be angry. Yeah. I'm sure of it.
Controversial.
Max Schimm live here in the studio playing... well, we're going to find out what he's playing. A song from The Doors here on 91.3 KSBY-FM Sonoma.
Don't you love her madly? Don't you need her badly? Don't you love her ways? Tell me what you say. Don't you love her madly? Wanna be her daddy? Don't you love her face? Don't you love her as she's walking out the door? Like she did 1,000 times before. Don't you love her ways? Tell me what you say. Don't you love her as she's walking out the door? All your love, all your love, all your love, all your love, all your love is gone. So sing a lonely song of a deep blue dream. Seven horses seem to be on the mark. Yeah, don't you love her? Don't you love her as she's walking out the door? All your love, all your love, all your love, yeah. Yeah, all your love is gone. So sing a lonely song of a deep blue dream. Seven horses seem to be on the mark. Don't you love her madly? Don't you love her madly? Don't you love her madly? Don't you love her so? Yeah, yeah. Gotta love her so. Yeah, yeah. Boy, I love her so. Yeah. Yeah, gotta love her so.
Well, that was very respectable, my friend. That was very good. Now, vocal-wise, you never had any training for vocals either, did you? Or did you go to vocal coach?
I did not. Well, this year is the first time I've done that, and I went to see a coach before we started the whole Doors thing because I was like, I really want to fine-tune, you know? Right. There's a lot of mechanics behind singing, which comes naturally to some people, and for me, I don't feel like it comes as naturally. So
the whole breathing thing is something. You get halfway through a verse and realize you're going to pass out because you haven't inhaled.
Right.
The entire
how to do
room.
That. Yeah. So I've been seeing this lady in town. Her name's Allie Cicchetti, and she's been great. I've done a couple of sessions with her and worked with her before some of my gigs, and she's been a big help. So
nice.
I'll plug her. I think her website is thevoicestudio.com, or just look up Sonoma Vocal Lessons. She's one of the first people that'll come up and Google
I had
search.
I had no idea we had that kind of thing in town.
Yeah, yeah. She's great. She's helped out a great deal.
Well, so. I mean, I knew Madeline Wild is here, who did voiceover training that kind of thing, but I didn't know we had musical vocals. Probably 10 of them are going to email me now and tell me, you know, hey, well, I'm a vocal
sorry
coach.
About that. I'm sorry.
No, that's good. That's good. I need to know these things. So now I notice you have a string missing on that guitar.
Yeah.
Is that on purpose?
This is a patented 11 string.
Is that on purpose or is it just broken? You
I
never
just,
put one
you
on.
Know, I lost this pin, so there's only... So
you're not trying to Keith Richard us or anything?
No, no, nothing like that, yeah.
This is my own style of tuning. I've decided I only want one G string.
That's right, yeah. So,
well, the G string's always the biggest hassle, so it's probably less of a hassle to
that's
keep
right.
that 12 string.
So I got the low G here, and... yeah, it's been missing for a while, but I've just gotten used to it at this point. 11 strings.
Some works don't fix it. So is a 12 string your only instrument? Do you have 6 string?
No, I got a 6 string Martin that desperately needs to be fixed. It's just the action's kind of out of whack right now.
Well, you know who the Martin guy in town is, right?
Do I? No.
Chris, when I bought Chris, it's Chris Hanlon.
Chris Hanlon, okay.
Yeah, I went and bought my Martin at Toad.
Yeah.
And I'm all, well, can I have my guy set this up? And they're like, oh, we don't know. You know, that's that might violate the warranty. Who's your guy?
Huh.
I said, Chris Hamlin. They're like, oh, he's our Martin warranty guy.
Oh, okay. All right.
Okay, fine. So, yeah.
Good to know, yeah.
Chris, I'll set you up with his number
afterwards.
Cool,
cool. Good deal.
There's nobody that touches my guitars other than Chris Hamlin.
Great. Okay, good to know. Yeah. Was he on your show a few
I had him a few while back. Okay. He's an interesting cat and got a lot of musical history and an amazing luthier as well. There's a little plug in there for Chris.
Cool.
But, yeah, get that over to him and he'll plan on spending some time because he'll talk to you about your instrument.
Good deal, good deal. Yeah, right on.
So now, do you play when you play guitar? I mean, are you mainly acoustic, like rhythm and singing, or do you do guitar solos as well?
I try to do guitar solos, but I'm not too much of a lead player. Although I try to be sometimes, and you know, I can throw. I like to throw a few licks here and there into a lot of the different songs that I'm doing, but I don't fancy myself as like a ripping guitar player. But I think some of my favorite bands aren't even like shredding bands. You know, I love Eddie Van Halen, but like Gilmore is a great example of how you can just make certain notes sing, and you only. Every note counts when Gilmore plays.
David Gilmour has some of the most phenomenal guitar tone of any, even today. His guitar tone is just ridiculously good.
Yeah, another big influence of mine is Queens of the Stone Age, and they approach guitar solos very, very strangely, I think.
Now, did you ever get into Caius?
Before? Oh, yeah. Well, I got into them after I listened to Queens.
I discovered Caius like in the middle of the 2000s. And I was like, where can I go see these guys? They're like, they broke up 12 years. They broke up 12 years ago. Well, because in the 90s, I quit listening to rock music. I was mad at rock music.
What a time to stop listening. What are you talking about, man?
I didn't know. Well, that was the reason I quit.
Oh, okay.
Because the music I was good at, grunge killed. I was mad at rock. I mean, I played hard rock and heavy metal, you know, and that went right. I mean, literally, people lost their record contracts in a day.
Right.
It's like, okay, well, we don't need you anymore. We're hiring these guys in t-shirts and flannels.
And
guys just fell right off the map.
It is crazy.
So I was mad at rock and roll. So I went, that's when I fully joined Southbound, and we toured, and my guys were all out of college.
Yeah.
And so we toured, you know, played regionally around all of Northern California, and I joined a Southern Rock Tribute Act for 10 years.
Right.
So, and then I got back into music in the 2000s, and I heard all this rock stuff, and I was like, oh, this is actually pretty good, and this isn't really grunge. These guys are rock.
Oh, yeah. They're very weird. They're like desert. They're straight out of the desert. They're very brutal sounding.
The whole Imperial Valley, I guess, or the Sun Valley. Down in
Palm Springs Desert out that way. So it's really cool. They've come up with really unique stuff, and a big part of their music was sounding like no one else at that time.
And it
shows to this day.
Well, they brought back echoplexes. I mean, I realize you're not a proper stoner rock band unless you have an echoplex.
What is it? I don't even know
an
what
echoplex
that is.
It's a thing that makes the guitar go woo, 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 woo,
oh,
woo,
okay, woo, okay, yeah.
And slows it down and then speeds it up. Yeah. Well, in the 70s, Tommy Bolin had those, Pat Travers had those, Richie Blackmore had those.
Yeah.
A lot of those solos you hear on, like, Made in Japan, where you're speeding things up and slowing things down. That's all an echoplex.
Okay.
And I always wanted one. And so, anyway, we're live in the studio with Max Schimm on 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. I am your host, James Marshall Berry. We'll talk more about your Doors thing and the show you got coming up.
Sure.
There's a big show at the El Verano Inn. Is that where it is?
Yeah,
El Verano Inn. And we'll talk more about that. But you have other, I mean, I see half a dozen acts. It prop you up in front of them at like the farmer's market and stuff, and then you're singing some other song. I mean, I know John's been a good partner for you, John Arntz. And you're well known. You're becoming well known, obviously, in the circle, the local musician circle. So do you have people who just reach out to you and go, "Hey, you want to do a tune with us?"
Every now and again, yeah. Well, there's definitely some regulars, Lino and the Riots. I do Roadhouse a lot with a lot of people.
Yeah.
It's gotten to the point where I'm like, I hate this song.
Yeah, right.
No, I mean, it never gets old for me, really.
If I never play "Can't You See" again, I'll be happy. But it's the song everybody wants to hear, so I play it. I just realized I'm going to play it and smile.
Just get through it. No, I love Lynn and her band. It's a lot of fun to play with them.
They're good folks.
John. It's mostly there's just been a smattering of other projects. Wildflower Weed. I used to sing a couple songs with them.
Oh, I did. Why did I not know that?
Yeah.
Since half my family's in that band.
We used to do right, exactly. Yeah. I love them dearly, and they got such a cool thing going on, man. But we used to do Nothing Else Matters, and. I kind of
do remember a little bit of that.
Yeah, maybe one other tune that I can't remember off the top of my head, but
they
were kind of the first band that I was kind of
gigged out with.
Yeah, gigging out with like consistently, even though it was just for three songs. But yeah,
Your feet wet.
Yeah,
that's excellent.
Yeah.
Well, before we get to the next break, let's hear another tune. You got
something else?
Is it another Doors tune? You got a surprise us
No,
or something?
No, I'll do something.
We don't have to be all Doors. You want to save something for the show.
I know, right? Yeah, I want to. Yeah, just enough. I got a Billy Idol song, actually.
Billy Idol.
I brought some lyrics because I think I was going to forget the last couple verses.
I only need the first word of every verse.
Okay.
Otherwise, I'll sing the third verse first. It's just going to happen. Max Schimm, live here in the studio on 91.3 KSVY Sonoma.
Alone, it's easy to deceive. tease, hard to get a release. Your eyes without a face, your eyes without a face, your eyes without a face, got no human grace, your eyes without a face. Leaving all the lies to keep the dream alive. Now it makes me sad, makes me mad at truth. Loving what was you. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes without a face. Eyes without a face, got no human grace. Eyes without a face. My eyes, and I wonder why I don't despise. Now all I can do is love what was once so alive and new, but it's gone from your eyes. Your eyes without a face. Your eyes. Without a face, eyes without a face, got no human grace, your eyes without a face.
Max Schimm live here in the studio on 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. You know, I've heard a lot of Billy Idol tunes covered. I don't think I've ever heard anybody cover that song.
Oh, yeah?
No, I really don't. I think that was the first time I heard it, and yeah. Well done.
Thank you. Thank you.
We're going to quickly take a break and hear a word from our sponsors. Do not go away, and we will be right back with more from Max. I'm going to talk about the big show coming up,
yeah.
And how that. I'm curious as to how that whole thing got together, but we're going to find out about that and more. In fact, what his favorite toy was as a child, I'm not exactly sure, but we're gonna touch on some things. So stick around, we'll be right back. Well, those are good words from the pirate. I can't encourage you to do things because we can't call to action on community radio, KSVY, but I am going to go to KSVY.org and I'm going to hit the donate button, and maybe you should as well. I am your host, James Marshall Berry. We are here live in the studio with Max Schimm on the New Old Show on 91.3 KSVY-FM Sonoma. I had a whole bunch of things I was going to say, and now they've just left my mind because I heard the Allman Brothers. And now, you know, you're back in town. You're playing music. You know, you did your college thing. Yeah. You got a regular job and doing well and living back on the east side, and I mean the west side. And, I mean, musically... Do you have any aspirations? I mean, I always still think that if, you know, some touring act by some act of God called me up and said, hey, we need a bass player for a 6-month tour. Are you in? That I would leave. I would drop everything and go on the road.
Yeah.
I mean, do you have any aspirations like that? Or at this point, it's like you just, you know, pardon, you know, not to say this is bad, but just along for the ride in the view here in the local town and playing some music and having fun.
There's a lot I want to do with music.
Yeah.
And if I had the chance to tour and be with some bandmates who we really bond and play well together, that would be like my ultimate thing. Even if it's just living in a van, I want to do the whole Nirvana thing. You know,
I'm past the van thing. I'd sleep in a hotel room with the drummer in a separate bed. But I you know, I don't know if I could live in a van. I mean, camping to me at this age is, you know, a motel without room service. That's camping.
Yeah.
So, yeah there won't be any living in the van. But you could live
sure.
in a van
sure,
down
do
by
I
the
could
river.
Do it, man. Yeah.
So that would be an original project, then, I imagine.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Because,
yeah, I would like
so
to,
you'd be paying dues and yeah. going, you know, going from place to place, and there's no record deals anymore. So now it's all about yeah. selling merch, and you yeah. know, I mean, and even giving away music. I mean, we try to buy physical music from the band so that
right.
they can at least make money. But even that's hard because I'll hear bands, and you'll want to support them, and it's like, but then they came around, you know, so it's. It's hard to give bands money these days. That's the whole thing. But
yeah.
so you would that might be something.
I definitely, man. Yeah, it's I definitely in terms of the future.
I mean, I'm how old are you? I mean, I think
I'm
you're the same age as my daughter, right?
Well, I'm turning 28 in a couple of weeks.
Right.
Yeah, getting close.
Right. So yeah, 28. God, yeah. 28.
I gotta make my 20s count, you know.
I'm thinking. Okay, what year was that? That was 1988 for me. Wow. Okay, different time.
Huh?
Different time indeed. So anyway, you're thoroughly into the Doors, and who put this idea of a door? You know, because there's honestly not a lot of Doors tribute acts around, and you know when
yeah.
we. You know, the tribute acts are the thing now. I mean, I have my guitar teacher. He plays original music, and he's like, play music and enjoy yourself. Have fun.
Yeah.
That's the most
yeah.
important thing. And if people are digging you, people are digging you. That's his trip.
Sure.
And which is cool. Like I say, I played in the original acts, and then I like playing. I mean, I like playing other people's songs. And when we did backtracks for 10 years or so here, I mean, it was our goal to sound just like the record, because
yeah,
that's what people
yeah.
want to hear. Even when you go see some of these bands, they don't play the song anything like a record, and people say, well, that's not creative, you're just, you know, a copy, you're a tape recorder.
Well,
but you know, we'd have people walk up and go, god, we thought you guys were a CD player from across the park,
right?
And that was the biggest compliment we could get, because
exactly.
that's exactly what we were trying to do.
Yes. Yeah,
so
exactly.
So like it or love it, we did what we wanted to do. So you know, the tribute acts are huge right now. People I know that were in original bands that, you know, toured, you know, small arenas
yeah.
are now in local tribute acts that play with us at places like the Big Easy and Spanky's in front of, you know, 150 people, where we all walk away with $37 and a burger and a pack of smokes. So, you know, I mean, that's kind
it's
of the
though.
Thing that we're, it is fun. It is really fun. So you decide you're going to put this Doors thing is going to come together. How did that happen? Did you approach John, or tell me the story of that?
Yeah. John and I had done, like I said, we'd kind of done some projects here and there. And we did, are you familiar with Friends with Benefits, that project?
Yes. Yeah. That's one of John's many, John can't sit still. As we
No,
know.
he's the busiest guy
yeah.
I think I've ever seen in my life.
You want to know if John can do something? No, he has practice. For one of
yeah,
them.
Right.
And God
yeah.
bless him for that.
Yeah,
I guess
yeah.
he started late, so he's catching up.
Right. So anyways, we did Friends with Benefits in October of 2022. And afterwards, he was like, let's try to think of something to do where we're not just like, you know, teasing each other.
Right.
And then coming back every so often, every couple of months. So earlier this year, I was kind of getting back into the Doors, rediscovering my love for them. And I reached out to John. I was like, what if we do a Doors tribute act? Because every time I would ask for them to do a Doors song for karaoke or the Friends with Benefits, they just would blow the roof off the place. And
right,
so it
right.
just felt like and from there, he knew kind of the right people to line up for the project. And it's been amazing so
well,
far.
Now who's in the act? Cliff Z
yeah,
is the keyboard.
Yeah,
and
Cliff
I've been in bands with Cliff for him and I were in the Burdick band, and we're still occasionally Burdick calls, and you know, Burdick is one of those guys that could call and go, hey, I got a tour, you on, you in? I'd leave, you know. And so I've done played with Burdick and Davo, who
Davo
I don't
Farrell,
know
yeah.
well, just one of the, he's like Michael Noel. I mean, he's quietly an unbelievably good musician.
Yeah.
And he plays his own style and has his own tone, and he cops those Robbie Krieger licks.
Oh man,
to a T. Well, not even looking at what he's doing and smiling, and
that
is so cool to see.
He's him and Cliff, like they'll just figure stuff out during our rehearsal, and it's incredible.
It was ingrained in them. It was like Lynyrd Skynyrd songs to me, or something. I think those are the songs these guys grew up.
Right. It's true. I know they grew up with it. So
the melody's
perhaps,
in there.
Yeah, exactly. Perhaps once upon a time they learned some of those licks, but they it's an amazing thing. They're all masters of the craft.
Yeah.
And Michael Gay, who's on the drums.
That's what I was wondering, who's on drums. Yeah. I don't know him well, but every time I've seen him, I've had to ask John, hey, who's that drummer?
Yeah.
And the answer is always, oh, it's Michael Gay.
Yeah. I mean, he's got great time, and he does it so well. He does the Densmore thing so well, where the drumming is kind of, it's like for the Doors, it's very circusy and theatrical, you know?
Oh, yeah.
The drumming.
Yeah.
It's got these really staccato things, and then there's something that's really intricate, like Break On Through, which is this bossa nova groove, this bossa nova drum beat, and he can just cop anything like the rest of those guys. And John does a really great job of orchestrating. He'll make charts for everybody.
Oh, John's the king of charts.
Oh yeah,
There's not he hates trees. There's so much paper.
No, it's great. I'm learning so much just from being in a room with all those guys when we rehearse, because they're so much more experienced in rehearsal. I'm learning a lot.
There's a way to practice and there's a way not to
definitely
practice. I've been in bands where it's like, this is absolutely futile. We're not getting anything done here.
Exactly.
Even though we're playing for 4 hours, we're not doing anything.
Right.
And there's other bands, you get together and 2 hours of rehearsal and let's put this to bed.
Yeah.
You know, we're ready to roll.
Yeah. It's super productive. But, you know, we're oftentimes just giggling like schoolgirls because of how much fun we have. And it sounds so good a lot of the time that we look over at each other and smile. And it's every time we get together, it's the highlight of my week, you know?
Well, you know, band practice, I mean, I've been doing band practice. It's my original bands. We literally had band practice 6 nights a week. I mean, it was what we were doing. Yeah. What are you doing tonight? Well, we're going to band practice.
Oh, man.
So over the 45 years, you know, it's turned into getting to band practice is always a hassle. But once you're at band practice, it's like, I don't want to be anywhere else.
Yeah.
You know?
Well, it's a different kind of difficult to get everybody together sometimes because all those musicians are in like two or three other projects at any one time, so it's just to get
us so
together
fickle.
Is a chore.
So fickle.
But it makes for a fun, I think having that space in between rehearsals and gigs is a fun thing because it makes you appreciate it a lot more when you come back to it, and you come back to it with a fresh set of eyes and ears, you know?
Yeah. You got another Doors tune for us before we get out of here?
Yeah, let me...
I'm thinking you have one or two, maybe.
You know what? I do. I gotta grab a capo for this next one.
Oh, he's capoing.
Yeah.
Fancy stuff.
Yeah, I forgot.
You gotta have more all the stuff, more things you have attached to the top of your headstock, the more experienced you are. It seems like
you
know, I got nine different
tuner,
things.
A capo,
something for your smoke or whatever.
Right?
You know,
I'm not there yet, but one
right, day. Right, yeah, you're not, yeah. Jimmy Page would just stick his smoke in the headstock with his guitar.
Yeah.
We're live in the studio with Max Schimm. You're listening to 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. I am your host, James Marshall Berry. We're going to hear a quick tune from Max, and we're going to talk more about this this big show. It's not New Year's Eve, is it?
It's the day before. December 30th.
It's a pre-game New Year's Eve
That's
show.
That's right. That's right.
Okay,
it's
the
Saturday,
30th. Well, we're going to talk more about that, but in the meantime, we're going to hear from Max right now on 91.3 KSVY FM.
Before you slip into unconsciousness, I'd like to have another kiss, another flashing chance at bliss, another kiss, another kiss. The days are bright and filled with pain. Enclose me in your gentle rain. The time you ran was too insane. We'll meet again. We'll meet again. That never die. Deliver me from reasons why you'd rather cry. I'd rather fry. Look crystal chef is being found. A thousand girls, a thousand thrills, a million ways to spend your time. When we get back, I'll drop a line.
Very nice. Well, you do a very respectable Jim Morrison. So I anticipate that this show will be great. Once again, this is coming up next Friday. I'm not a calendar guy.
Saturday.
Yeah, next Saturday at the El Verano Inn, one of the last places you can truly rage and rock. I mean, they had a punk rock show not long ago.
That's right. Yeah.
You know, when we had the real, Kevin's place, we could still rock there. But I mean, they had punk rock at Murphy's the other night. I was too sick to go down there. Kay Bruno and her band were down there. So it's nice at those places, but the El Verano Inn, truly one of the classic old bars here in the Valley. One of the last roadhouses left between the Washoe House and those kinds of things. I mean, it's been there since 1887, and every time I go in there, the floor is a little more crooked. I mean, living down the street, I've stumbled on the flat parts of that bar. So what time do you go on?
We're going on from 8 to 10.
8 to 10?
Yeah.
So it's two sets?
We're doing two sets, yeah. There's no cover charge. So
and no opening in. Act? It's
no openings,
just you guys?
Yeah.
So if you like The Doors or you like good music in general, you'd like to see Max and his act next Saturday. Now any other shows coming up? You could do a solo act. I mean, between the songs you've got. Have you ever done a solo act?
I've done a few solo acts. Yeah, I've played at a few wine bars, like Wine Snob most recently over in Glen Ellen. They've had me. And that was a while ago, but I don't do them a whole lot, but every now and again I'll usually bring my electric guitar and have like a loop pedal and kind of noodle around a little bit.
You could do this, we just did here. You'd entertain plenty of people.
Appreciate
Max,
that.
I want to thank you for coming in. I don't know if you had to take time off work today, but I do appreciate you being here. Max Schimm, once again, not this Saturday, but next Saturday at the El Verano Inn. The name of the band escapes me. It's
Strange Days.
Do you think I would know that? And people can find out more about the act how? On the Book of Faces, I imagine?
Yeah, on the Book of Faces, we're on there. We've got an Instagram page or a website, strangedazemusic.com.
Strange, D-A-Z-E.
Yeah, D-A-Z-E. Okay. Like you're in a daze.
Daze so music.com. An actual website. Man, how old school.
Yeah, right.
Look at you go. Oh, I guess you know how to build them, don't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, you know.
A little bit.
Helps
yeah.
to have that
yeah, yeah.
Skill
helps
set.
To have that skill. Well, you know, you get something out of Chico other than how to drink beer. Thanks for coming in, Max. You've been listening to 91.3 KSVY FM Sonoma. We will not have a new live show next week. There will be something in the can. I do not know what I'll be running. I want to wish everybody a happy holiday and a happy new year. We will not be back until January 3rd with new shows here on the New Old Show. Do stick around. The guys at Fiverr Next and Littleworth Jams will be in the studio, and that will be fun, along with the other guys at Five Witty Banter that they do. Anyway, we are done. Have a great holiday, everybody. Cheers. Thanks for tuning in.